never gets home.
Players come, players go. But a team that is a family is unbreakable.
Hello, everyone. We are pleased to bring you the 14th installment of our Learn, Create, and Grow webinar series, Game Asset Design, brought to you by Technicolor Creative Studio Academy. I am Soumya Dipta Roy, but out of love, people call me Roy. I too am a trainer at the Academy, and it's a true delight to have you all here today. Our team is thrilled to have you all here, and we urge you to stay until the end as we have some fantastic prizes to give away. Learn, Create, and Grow is a webinar series designed specifically for students and artists by Technicolor Creative Studios Academy. The masterclasses provide students with a unique opportunity to gain an understanding of the work of various disciplines within the VFX industry. We introduced a new episode each month that enables artists like you to explore a broad range of topics through VFX masterclasses conducted by our expert trainers. Today, we examine the skills associated with game asset design. But before we go any further, let me introduce our esteemed speaker, Koushik Chatterjee, who is a seasoned professional with a wealth of experience spawning from more than 15 years in the creative field, with a remarkable portfolio encompassing the creation of diverse game assets, characters, and immersive environments. Koushik has also lent his artistic talents and knowledge to prestigious high-profile feature films, commercials, and even Hollywood projects. Among these films that he has worked on is Fashion, Race, Race 2, Inception, and Muran. In the recent year, Koushik has moved into the role of 3D instructor, sharing his knowledge and experience with many, many talents across different regions. Presently, he's a trainer at Technicolor Creative Studio, and he continues to inspire and nurture the next generation of artists in the vast field of animation. For Koushik, teaching is not merely a profession, but also a great fulfillment, and he likes to empower others so that they can find success in the exciting world of animation. Let's hear from Koushik Chatterjee himself.
Thank you, Roy, for the kind introduction. Hello, everyone. I am Koushik, a game assets trainer at Technicolor Creative Studio Academy. I am excited to share my experience in game assets design with you today. Without further ado, let's get started with our webinar on the art of game assets creation. By the end of this webinar, you will gain a clear understanding of what is game assets modeling and the whole pipeline of game assets modeling. Let's begin. In video games, game assets design refers to the creation and preparation of various digital elements. These assets are essential to the development of a game and including everything from character, environment, and object to user interface elements, sound effect, and music. It is both an aesthetic, artistic, and a technical aspect of game development that goes into the creation of game assets. An important factor in the overall success of a video game is the quality and detail of its assets. Second one, creating 3D game assets involves several stages from the initial concept to the final level. Here is the pipeline for 3D game assets creation. Begin with basic shapes to block out the overall forms of the assets. Focus on proportion, scale, and sell out. This stage helps in getting a sense of an asset size and shapes without diving into details. Create a detailed version of the assets. Add fine details, surface imperfections, and intricate features. Use sculpting tools for organic model or detailed modeling techniques for half surface object. This model is often used for cinematic or high quality renders. Generate a simplified version of the high poly model stable for real-time rendering in games. Focus on reducing the polygon while relating the essential details. Maintain the shell out and overall shapes of the high poly model. Consider the topology for optimal deformation during animation. Unwrap the low poly model to create 2D UV coordinates. Optimize UV layouts for efficient texture resolution and minimum distortion. Ensure there is minimal stitching and overlap in the UV map. Create texture for the 3D model using software like Substance Painter or Photoshop. Apply color maps, normal maps, specular maps, and other texture maps. Ensure textures are optimized for performance considering the target platform and engine. Generate simplified version of the model for different LODs. Each LOD should have fewer polygons to improve performance in various distance from the camera. LOD are crucial for optimize the game's performance by reducing the rendering load. Export the final low poly model, texture and LODs in format compatibly with your game engine. Import the 3D assets into the game engine, set up materials and shaders. Configure LOD setting with the engine. Testing and optimization. Test the assets in different scenes and lighting conditions. Optimize assets for better performance if needed. Adjust LOD distance and other settings. The key priority for someone looking to become a game asset designer is to understand the principle of modeling, studying the core principle of modeling such as low poly model, mid poly model, high poly model, and sculpting.
Thank you, Koushik, for that wonderful session. Let's take a quick break and play some trivia where you have some chances to win some exciting prizes. Just pay attention to the question and type in the answers in the chat box as quickly as possible. Alright, the first question is, what is the process of 3D modeling technique that involves manipulation of vertices, edges, faces to create the desired shape? Next question. Which keys are the shortcut for undoing an action in Autodesk Maya? What is the purpose of bevel operation in Autodesk Maya's modeling tools? In which phase of modeling can we really focus on proportion, scale, and silhouettes? In Autodesk Maya, how can we add edges to a polygonal model? Keep an eye on your inbox as our team will contact the winner via email. Thank you all for sharing the answers. we invite you to take advantage of the opportunity to explore the Academy's courses and learn more about the application process by clicking on the link in the upper right corner of your screen. Additionally, you can access our past webinars by clicking on the link in the description box below. And thank you very much, Koushik Chatterjee.
To become proficient in game assets designer, it is important to practice regularly and refine your skills.
Hello everyone. Now I am starting to create the blocking part. So first, I have to take a camera, and after that I am going over there in attribute editor, create, and here is the file location, and this is the image. So now you can see there is a tree out for the blocking part first. So for the distance, I am increased the focal length, and for the beginning, I am taking a cylinder for making that root part. So I am reducing the height and radius. Also, I am reducing the subdivision level. Now scale up that bottom part, selecting my vertex. So now you can see there is a camera view as well as the perspective view. So I have to see the camera view and also the perspective view. Very consciously, I have to maintain the mesh flow, taking another topology there also and making them as you can see the shape. So from the beginning, you have to make them very, according to the scale. So you can see my mesh movement. So it's going according to the, volume or flow. It should be going nicely, neat and clean. Right, now you can see the camera view as well as the perspective view. Here is, I am taking a topology over there. Now I am going for the component option. For the component option, it gives me according to the, face direction. So it gives me the local axis and so on. So I have to make that branch according to the shape. So now you can see the camera angle. It looks nice. And according to the camera view, it is matching perfectly. A little bit of more topology I am giving over there so that the shape will be coming very fine. So there I need to a topology for this kind of shape. So what I need to do, I have to first create a round shape so that I am making it the flow. So I am giving the all edges for circulate. So I am circulate that edge over there and selecting the whole edge with the help of the double click and make it circulate. So you can see the topology has been circled. Also over there, the same trick, I am giving it the circulate topology. So I am going with the help of the tools. I am not going with the manual detailing. So this is give me the exactly what I want. Now I am make that polygon straight. It should not be looked very deformed. So the topology should be nice and clean. So now I'm selecting this topology and scale according to the global axis. Now it is comes very straight. Same process over there also. Select the topology from there and make it straight. Now I am going to make that top leaves portion. So now you can see there is a stylized leaves over there. So for that, I am taking a spare, and with the help of the spare, I have to make that part. So now there is the camera view. I have to set the camera view. So I am trying to match the camera and also the perspective. And I am selecting that edge and make that scale up so that that broad part, it's coming very easily. So you can understand what I am trying to do. Now that edge, I have to make it scale down. So the tip portion of the tree. Also giving some topology for get the shape over there. And overall, I have to check, and I am snapping that edge. It's much better, looks much better. And you can see I am not giving so much of topology over there, just a few topology, and I am trying to giving the shape according to my image reference. So what I need there, I want some additional topology. So only that's why I am taking that topology. Otherwise, unnecessarily, we are don't using to create some topology over there. And I am getting that on-off button. So that I am getting for the scripting. Now that is a trace. I am looking for a topology over there so that I am taking the multi-cut and make it like this, because with the if you want topology over there, and if you want to use that insert edge loop tool, so that can't be worked over there because there is a tri-shape. That's why I am making that kind of thing with the help of the multi-cut. Now I am using the soft selection tool so that I can get the shape over there, because you can see the front part is going up and the back part of that leaf portion is coming down. So that's why I am making in that way. Yes, it looks more nice. I think it looks perfect for according to the image reference save. And as you know, that is a stylus model. So I need to check again and again it is right or wrong direction. So now I am taking some topology over there to make a round. Yes, now it looks perfect. Now you can see the camera angle. Now I am pressing 3. This is the soft. Yes, now it looks nice. I am creating that small branch over there. Now I am snap that over there and rotate it little bit. So pivot point and snapping and placing is very important for the blocking part. So your pivot point where should be, that is very also important. So I am not going to the according to the grid or very straight way. So I am molding little bit of the part according to my image reference. I am taking a cube for creating that leaves over there in the right side. Now making some topology over there. Now you can see the shapes, how it looks like. So after giving some extra look over there, I am trying to get that shape. It is very important what kind of technique you are applying to create that blocking part. So that comes for the practicing a lot and experience. Now here is that part of that tree. So now you can see how it looks like. Now here is the, you can see I am using two different ways. The first one is the top one. I have made that part with the help of the sphere. And the second one, I am making that with the help of the cube. The third one, for the left hand side, again I am taking a sphere and match the camera angle and spacing and make it in that way. Select in the soft selection tool. I am trying to match the silhouette. After that, I have extruded that upper portion to make that small part. From there, and here is the output. You can see how it looks like. Some sort of adjustment. I'm selecting the upper face. I'm selecting the upper face again, and make it extrude, and make a topology over there. Very little changes. Now, I match the camera angle. Now there is my blocking first level of blocking part. Now you can see if I press soft, now it looks like that. That is only for the creating the shape according to the size and scale. Now I am going to that second part, like this is the mid poly level. So I am preparing that model for the high poly modeling. Okay, so in that part, I need some extra topology over there, and also I am creating that rock part over there. So let's start. So I have to make that rock like this. So I am taking a multi-cut and make a topology from F over there according to the rock shapes, and that I am creating in different way. That part should be the different from that tree. you can see it is very uneven, and I am going to extract that portion. So now you can see there is a two part, that is the, that bottom part is the rock part, and there is the upper part is the tree part. Okay, so in the whole part I have to make that rocks over there. Now gradually I am going to that for the high poly model, so I am preparing that for the high poly model. So that's why I am taking some little bit of topology over there. Meanwhile, you will just remember that in the high poly model or for the gaming purpose, tri-phase is acceptable, okay, but the 5 vertex or 6 vertex, it is not acceptable for game assets creation. So tri-phase and quad, it only acceptable. So now I am looking at the depth over there. So there is a plenty of depth. That means somewhere there is the negative space, that is the negative space, and somewhere you can see this positive space. So what is the positive space? Which is come out, that is the positive space, and which is goes down little bit of inside, that is our negative space. So positive and negative space we have to define so that the things will come out according to the shape. Now you can see the space is coming gradually. So that comes out, that means that is the positive space, and which it goes down, that is the negative space. So I have to define that space over there. From the beginning, don't go for plenty of topology over there. Just take that much of topology which you need. So I am saying again and again, they're the same topic, but that thing is very crucial for game assets design, because after the blocking part, I am going for the mid poly. And you can say I am preparing that model for the high poly detailing. So high poly detailing, where we can get the, you know, depth over there, negative space, positive space, cutting over there, detailing over there. So that space I need to create in the mid poly level. Now you can see the things is coming gradually. That it's okay. I am taking some topology over there. So now you can see how it looks like. See, there is the seal out, the size, the scale, the perspective according to the image reference. This looks nice. Plenty of up and down over there. Now I am going to the bottom part, so I am create some detailing over there. So I am make sure that there is no 5 vertex over there. and as much as possible, my topology should be neat and clean. So I need to manipulate the topology. Now you can see the topology is neat and clean. It looks nice. The edge is hard. Selecting that edge so that I can define a little bit of making distance. Now I snap that part, so it should be snapped with that empty space, and the vertex should be snapped according to the shape, and there should be no gap. I think there should be no gaps over there. It should be joined very well. For the joint purpose, you need to snap that vertex, because we have already two objects, that is, one is the stone part and one is the tree part. The flow should be neat and clean, so that's why I am giving it the flow already. I am creating the edge flow over there. And I am taking a topology in between. So the distance should be very same. Now I am going to that part, that tree upper part. The hair, the topology, should be some kind of different, like I'm giving the circulate way. Now it is pointed. So what I need to do, I need to create some different mesh flow over there. So I am selecting that edge and delete edge. Now I am connecting to the edge flow like this. So make sure where you can find this kind of shape, you have to make it like this. So now there is no need to be jitter or no such kind of pointed view. Here, the same process will be going on. Deleting that edge and make it joint like this. That is very important. Now also you can see there is a four vertex all over there. Now it's okay. Now there is the mid poly level of the detailing. So now it looks like this. There is a separate part.
I am going to start my high poly modeling in ZBrush. Now I am going to sub tool. Now you can see the all objects. You can see the all together. Now I am going to split the part. So now you can see the object has been splitted. So first I am selecting that root part, that branch. So I am going to sculpt over there. So now I am selecting the brush tool, that is all flattened brush. And I am going to start to create the volume and skin of the tree. So now you can see the tree skin is not very noisy or not very bumpy kind of. So that is very, you know, flat, smooth. And of course, you can see the corner over there. So that's why I am choosing that kind of brass who gives me that kind of effect. And I am creating that detailing with the level of 5, subdivision level of 5. After all, after that, we can increase the subdivision level definitely. Now you can see how the thing is coming. And definitely I am using the paint tab so that the paint tab gives me the paint sensibility. Here I am fill that portion. So in every bus, if you press Alt, so that the opposite sculpting process is coming. Like if you push in the normal way, that is the Z subdivision add, if you want to add some kind of addition. So if you get the normal things, and while you are pressing the Alt, definitely you are making that the different things like subdivision. You can subtract the surface. Now also I am selecting the clay builder brush. With the help of the clay builder brush, now I am adding some surface over there so that I can manage the more depth over there, and definitely I will get the depth from the different parts. So I hope you will understand that how much is necessary for the sketching and concept art. So that is very important for sculpting and as well as the modeling of the game assets. So sketching skill is very necessary so that you can understand very well and very quick, so that you can improve your, you know, visualization and plan according to the project. Now you can see that two different character in that stylized part. Like you can see that tree part is very, you know, flat surface over there. There is nothing, some kind of roundish area. But in that leaves part, no, you can see some kind of, you know, bulgy kind of things over there. And then the whole surface is roundish. And the only the flat portion you can see over that corner. Now I am adding some kind of surface over there, because you can see in the image reference, there is a part which is coming out. So according to the image reference, I am creating that part. And that is very roundish and soft. So that image reference or that assets distinguished and stylized. So every mood you can find over there. So in the rock part, you can see there is a very, very rigid mood, that is very sharp edge over there. In that plant, in that root part, you can see there is some kind of flat portion, but not very rigid as like the stone. I am making that second leaf part. Now you can see how it looks like. Nice. It is not even the very roundy. Looks nice. So selecting the object, selecting the if you have multiple object in your viewport, how you can select that kind of thing. So pressing Alt and click on the object which you want to select. So you can select automatically. And also now you can follow the polygon count. That means the whole polygon count is near about 19,967 millions, because I have already increased the subdivision level near about 8. Somewhere it should be 7, like this. Okay, now how it looks like, you can see over there. Now that is the undo part. So I am creating that one. So you can see the cut edges in the body of that root. So I am creating that with the help of the curve brush or curve brush. So that is coming in that way. So there the branch is very thin according to the, you know, root part. So that's why I am again decrease the brush size and sculpting over there. So now I am coming gradually in the back side. So in the back side I need to do over there. And I am creating the div exactly where my negative space is there. That is also very important. It looks better now. Now I'm going to that rock part, which is very important. So first I have to, you know, flat that whole part. Again, I am selecting the clay builder brush. And I am sculpting over there for the extra adding surface. So I am adding some surface over there with the help of the clay builder brush. So clay builder brush is very important and very nice brush in among the whole brush. So it's create what do you want, no? So it can comes very fast with the help of the clay builder brush. In website you can find some free extra brushes for sculpting purpose, for rock, for tree, for environment, whatever it is, maybe the softened and hardened edges. So you can download that brushes and you can use that brushes also, because that is very that brushes are very nice to sculpt. That is my plant, that is my rocks part, the bottom part, and the tree, the leaves. And you can see the poly count how it is. So only that part, the poly count, you can see the 1,88,400. I have to decimate that part. And after the going to plugins and 20% of decimation, going to 40% of decimation, and decimate and decimate. So you can see the poly count is decreasing 75,000 only. That is called decimation master actually. So in the decimation master, we can increase poly count without compromising my detailing. And here is the total poly count. So I'm going over there just before going export. So I have to save that part. So that is my ZBrush sculpting.
Now you can see that is my low poly model, which I have made in Maya. So I am importing that high poly model into the Maya. So there it is. You can see that is the rock part and there is my Maya model. So there is my sculpting detail over there. You can see over there. That is my tree and rock part. And that is my low poly model. So now what I have to do, I have to create a exactly same polygon which showing in the high poly model. Now I am separating that all object from my low poly. Now what we need to do, we need to do like according to the high poly mesh, I have to match the shape of the game rays model. Now here is the surface, you can see over there, I am matching the shell out with the high poly model. If I match the shell out with the high poly model while we are baking in substance painter, the detailing is exactly come with the low poly. Now you can see I am maintaining the shape so that extra surface which is upstairs, so I am down a little bit that vertex. Also I am snapping that part. Now here I can see the high poly as well as the game race. So I need to maintain the shape. I maintain the shell out. Now you can see over there also I am matching the shell out with the high poly model. Yes, now it looks nice and my topology is very less because that is my game race. I have already matched with that high poly level. Right now I am creating the LOD part. LOD means the level of detailing. The first model, that is LOD 0. So after I have to copy over there, that is LOD 1. And after that, I will copy that LOD 1. So that will be the LOD 2. Okay. So that is my LOD 0, first model. So now that is my LOD 1. So LOD 0 is the game race. LOD 1, I have to decrease my poly count. I am selecting those edges and delete it. So it should be not define the shape which I am deleting. That edge should not be define the shape. So that's why I am deleting. So very consciously I have to go. Now also you can see the poly count. So if the LOD 0 poly count is 3000, I have to make it LOD 1 1500, and also I have to make it in LOD 2 near about 700 to 750. So now 4000, there is near about 2500 approximately. 2500, yes. Now also I have to reducing that upper part and that rocks part also. Delete that in between phase. So now that is define the shape, so that's why I am not deleting that edge. It can be deleted. You can see over there and here the trees goes in the very far from the camera distance, so we can't recognize the shape over there. So that's why we are deleting the edge. You can see there is near about 2124. So that is the purpose. So there is the nearest one, there is the farthest one. Now we are creating the LOD 2. So that is LOD 0, that is 1. And duplicate that. So I am creating the LOD 2 model. Now that means I have to create another, I have to reduce another 50% of topology from LOD 2. That one delete. Delete it also. That is define the shape, but it is too far, so we can manage. Now I am merging that part. So tri-face is acceptable, as I said earlier. Now I am merging, that means I am reducing the poly count, but where we can't find the shape, so we can reduce that poly count in that way. After the game race, the texturing artist unwrap the UVs model. After that, we can create the LOD part. I am coming to that lower part. Now you can see 1364 polygons are there. Now I have to delete some extra loop over there. So very small chunk. If you not find the exact, dimension, so that's why we can delete it. The bigger chunk we can stay with that. No, that is fine. Now I am collapsing the edge. That means I am merging the edge simple way. One by one, which is not defined the shape. So now that is the main criteria. That is the LOD 0, that is the LOD 1, and that is my LOD 2. Now you can see how much polygons is there. I have to delete the history. Okay. So that is the main intention. So how far from your camera distance the object. Okay. So that's why we are creating the LOD, the level of detailing. Okay. So now LOD 0, LOD 1, and LOD 2. LOD0 should be your game rays. Now that is my LOD1, delete history, center pivot, freeze transformation and recess transformation is there. So now I can assure you, while you see the final output, you will be surprised how it looks like. So now that is my LOD. I am cleaning my viewport or my file. So after optimize the file, that is my LOD, final LOD. It looks like that. Now you can define the shape. The shape is similarly in LOD 0, LOD 1 and LOD 2. There is no definition of the shape, but the poly count is very less. Now that is my high poly model. So now there is some model you can see over there. So what I need to do, I have to create a composition with the help of this tree, the stylized tree. So that is our conceptual composition. So where the game race is happening. So I am scaling it with the help of the value. Now you can see the chunk of the rocks. So that I made in the ZBrush. The same process. And I am scaling up. Okay. Now you can see the environment look like this. Here is the steps in that is very detailing part. And here is the temple, the some rocks over there, and that is hanging. Okay. Now that is that high poly detailing model. That is the rocks and the tree. So now I have to compose that in a manner way so that it looks like a environment, okay? Because we are using the environment technique. Now, I am placement that rocks, placement that trees, as well as using that footage over there. Now, here I placement that kind of things. That is the rocks I have to place over there, or I have to orient. That is looks like a realistic environment. Now I am control that another part of rocks, which I have made in ZBrush right now. So actually that is our conceptual art. Now you can see I have make them settle over there. I have to now that is the pillar, the rocks, the everything I need to check again and again. So that is my final composition. You can see that is the steps and here is the rocks part, and you can see the detail over there. The detail is impact. And you can also notice that the file size is very, very low and very light so that I can move that full environment easily. Now there is the final composition. Now you can see the low poly game registry and the high poly detail. Okay. So that is output in the form Maya. And also I have to put a material over there. So now I just taking a bling, that basic material. We have to put the basic material over there and rename it properly. Now it looks like this. Okay. So that is my conceptual art as well as my stylized assets, you can see. Now here also, you can see the output from ZBrush. Here I can make it in default shadow and light. So it's looked like this. And also you can find there's a plenty of object, though the file is moving very smoothly. So that is the technique, how we use our game assets. So here is the output from ZBrush. You can understand the whole process from blocking to LOD from output. Okay, you will make that. Thank you very much.
Thanks to everyone who took part in the session. I hope you will enjoy it. Apply today and start your journey in game assets creation at Technicolor Creative Studio Academy. Thank you. Over to you, Roy.
And thank you very much, Koushik Chatterjee, for the wonderful, wonderful session. We extend our sincere thanks to all the participants who joined us for today's informative and engaging webinar. We hope you found it both valuable and enjoyable. Please feel free to contact us with any additional questions or inquiries through the contact details displayed on the screen. Please feel free to share the recording of this webinar with anyone who you think might find it beneficial. You can stay up to date with upcoming episodes and exciting content by staying connected with us on social media. In the meantime, keep those creative sparks alive and take care of yourself. We look forward to welcoming you back in the next installment of Learn, Create, and Grow.